Hey there, it's Mel here. I've got a really fun and creative way for you to bring some extra engagement to your live streams using custom overlays inside StreamYard. Now, you may be aware that you can upload transparent PNG files to add a little extra branding to your live videos, but did you know that you can also upload an animated GIF file? Even better, an animated GIF of yourself. Let's dive in. Now, I'm gonna show you how to create one of these, but first, let's make sure we all know what the heck I'm talking about. So here we are inside of the StreamYard studio, and here's what an overlay looks like. So you can create your own custom overlays using whatever design tools you want to use and upload a transparent PNG file. Here's an example of a custom one. Here's another one, right? But you can also upload animated GIF files as long as they're below 3 megabytes. So I always say, why not add a little extra you into your streams? So here's an example of what I'm talking about when I say add a custom animated GIF of yourself. There I am, looking a little bit confused. So this is a great way to add extra engagement, but also add a little custom excitement to your streams that will be unforgettable for your audience. So now let me show you how you can create your very own custom animated transparent GIF of yourself. Now, before we go too much further, I want to make sure that you understand that the process I'm going to show you is very much for the DIYer. You can absolutely hire somebody to do this for you or use the high-end Adobe Creative Suite products to actually do this as well. But I'm going to show you how to do this in some very simple apps such as Canva and Unscreen to create your transparent GIF file. Now, really quick, one of the things you're going to want to do is when you record your video, try to make it so that the beginning of your animation is similar to the end of your animation, because these are gonna be played on loop and you aren't gonna get it perfect, but you can get it pretty close. So you see here, I'm starting out in one position and then at the end of my video, it pretty much ends in the same position. And that's ideally what we're going for. Now you're gonna be able to trim your video so the beginning and the end of it out, but just make sure that you are trying to accomplish this particular type of scene. All right, now that we have your video, now let's talk about using Canva and Unscreen Pro to create the layout file as well as remove the background from your final animated GIF and uploading it into StreamYard. Okay, so we're in Canva because that's just the application that I use, but you could use any video creation application essentially to do this. So I'm in a video design. The dimensions are 1280 by 720. And we're gonna go to my uploads where I have uploaded my project that I wanna have, which is, of course, me looking confused. So I'm actually going to put this in the location that I want, which is gonna be, for me, in this lower right-hand corner. That's just kind of where I like to have my personal GIF show up. Obviously, as you know, you wanna leave a little margin at the bottom for banners and such. So here's my file. Here is my video. Now watch, I start out, I'm gonna trim this video because I want it to, it's gonna be on loop, and so I wanna make sure the beginning and the end are as closely matched as possible. And so I'm actually gonna trim this video right now. So I'm gonna trim out, I love Canva because it actually gives me a little bit of a preview where I'm trimming. I'm gonna go right to where I'm looking to the left, right there, because that's what I look like, that's kinda what I look like in the beginning of this video clip. So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna say done, we're good. I'm actually gonna export this video as an MP4. And then I'm gonna go to Unscreen and I'll show you how to make it an actual GIF. Now we're over here in this application called Unscreen. Now this application has its imperfections, but you definitely wanna be on the paid plan in order to create the type of files that we need. So we're gonna upload our video that we just created and we're gonna let it do its magic. It tends to take a few minutes sometimes and it's gonna give us a preview. Now the preview is really important because, as I mentioned, this application is not perfect, and sometimes the removal of the background is not correct. So we're gonna watch this preview a little bit. This file looks like it did it correctly because you don't pay for the file, or you're not, I guess it doesn't go against your credits until you actually process it. Now, one thing I wanna point out here is it's showing us the original and I want a transparent background. However, you can also use the application to pick an image in the back, a video. This is great for other type of social media uses, but for the use that we're using, we wanna pull this into our stream. And so now we're just gonna process the file. And so we're gonna click next, and it's gonna give us some options about how we wanna download it. We want an animated GIF. We want that to be a GIF because that's how we're going to be able to upload it into StreamYard as a transparent file, which is exactly what we're going to show you next. And now, as you can see, the file has processed. Now, it does take a little bit of time sometimes, but as you can see here, we get a preview, an actual preview of the final file, and it looks like we're good to go. Now, one thing I want to point out is this file has processed at 3.3 megabytes. So sometimes your file size will actually increase through all of the stuff that's happening. I have a little bit of a trick for us to downsize that file because StreamYard will not let us upload at this time a file that is over 3 megabytes for a GIF. Now we're gonna download this file, we're gonna save it, and then I'm gonna show you how a little trick on getting that resolution down if you don't have a video optimizer that will do it for you. So we're gonna download our file, we're gonna save it to our desktop. So next, I'm actually gonna go to Giphy and I'm going to upload my file that I just created. And so we're gonna select that file. It's actually this one. There's our file. And we're gonna go ahead and say, yep, we're good to go, we like it. We're gonna upload that to Giphy, which is gonna make it available for yourself, but also to others, depending on your account, of course. So once this file's here, we're gonna keep it. Okay, so now our animated file is in our account. So we're gonna go right here to Media, and then it's gonna let you download your actual source file, which we don't need to do that because we already have it on our computer. However, if we look at this social one, it actually is going to be a bit optimized. You can see here there's one that's even smaller. This typically reses it way down, just depending on the actual original file that you're working with. I like to try social first to see if I can get it under 3 megabytes. If that doesn't work, then I sometimes will go to the small. So then you just click download here, and we're gonna download again. I'm just gonna honestly save over my original because I don't need it. And we're gonna have that file. Now we're gonna check that file size. And it looks like it is perfect. It's not even a megabyte, so we're good to go. So the next step is you're gonna upload this to StreamYard and put it in your stream. And now here we are in StreamYard where we're gonna add this animated GIF file or GIF file to our overlay. So we're gonna upload the overlay. We're gonna pick it right here. We're gonna upload it. It takes a few seconds. Again, the file has to process. So you wanna make sure you prepare these in advance, not right before you're getting ready to go live. Okay, our animation has now been added. And here's what it looks like on screen. And this is gonna loop, so it's always gonna loop until you turn it off. And so that's one of the reasons why it's important to try to create your animation. The beginning of your animation, you should have the similar look on your face and similar position as the end of your animation. Now, I have a couple of other ones that I use all the time. They're really fun. They're not quite like that. Like this one, little me dancing around. And those are fun, and these add so much engagement. And so that's how you create your own personalized GIF that you can add to your stream. All right, there you have it. Now you know how to go DIY and create your own animated transparent GIF file of yourself to add into StreamYard for your streams. Now, sometimes people say, well, what should I do? What ideas, how do I get ideas? Honestly, I would recommend you pay attention to some of the GIF files that show up when you're using them on social media and replicate some of them. As you saw the mind-blowing one, that is one that I simply replicated and just used myself to make my own. So go get some ideas, be creative, write down a list, and then have a day, pick a day and have a lot of fun and create some transparent GIF files so you can get more engagement for your streams.